Well, a new twist in the red-hot controversy over illegal immigration. According to a new study, listen to this, 100,000 Hispanics have left Arizona since the state started debating its new immigration law. The study finds the exodus could stem from either the immigration law or the slumping economy. Joining me now is Ira Melman of the Federation for American Immigration Reform and Rayed Gonzalez, who works with the American Litigation Lawyers Association. Thank you, gentlemen, for talking to us. Ira, 100,000 Hispanics leaving Arizona. I mean, I guess the question should start by saying, you know, who exactly are we talking about that is leaving, and where have they all gone?
Well, it's not just Hispanics. It is people who are in the country illegally. And in Arizona, they are predominantly of Hispanic origin. And also, obviously, some family members who themselves may be legal are leaving with the illegal alien. But by and large, the law is working. It is doing precisely what it was intended to do. It was meant to discourage people from coming and settling in Arizona illegally. And it belies the contention that the only thing we can do with the millions of illegal aliens who are in the country is give them amnesty because they won't leave. In fact, what Arizona is proving is that if you institute sensible laws and you show a determination to enforce those laws, illegal aliens will react rationally and pick up and leave. Right now, they're going maybe to other states, but as fewer and fewer states are willing to accommodate illegal immigration, you're going to find more of them are deciding to go home.
Rayed, is the new law known as SB 1070, which partly went into effect in July, working, or is it possibly backfiring?
I really think it's working. For the first time ever, I'm going to agree with Ira on this one. I think it's really working. It's also preventing the entry of legal aliens into the United States. It's preventing a lot of them, other citizens from other states, to come to Arizona. It's destroying their economy. What else? Is this what really the statute was all about? If you think about it, Arizona was tourist-based, and right now nobody wants to go to Arizona.
But Rayed, sensing a little sarcasm here, obviously. I mean, you're saying that basically a law
just
in order to prevent some illegal aliens from entering the state of Arizona is in fact preventing legals from coming into this country, and more specifically in Arizona, and you think this is actually helping other states. What do you mean by that?
Texas recently has created, 166,000 new jobs this year only, when the rest of the nation has created like 266 total. It's incredible. We have seen an exodus of migrants coming to Texas, and we welcome them, actually. And not all of them are illegal, I can assure you of that.
Ira, I'm going to get to you in a second. I just got to ask Rayed. You know, first of all, some illegal aliens, some 23,000 plus, have actually believed to have returned to Mexico between June and September. So, I mean, isn't this proof that when laws against illegal aliens are enforced, just like Ira just pointed out here in Arizona, that by curtailing the non-essential, non-emergency public benefits and services to illegal aliens, that you're deterring illegals from coming into this country illegally? And by illegally, I mean dangerously. Some 30,000 Mexicans have died. And in 2010, because of the drug cartels, that number has actually exceeded the 10,000 person limit. I mean, isn't that the message that you want to send? You want to deter the crime, and by deterring illegals, you're reducing crime, no?
Julie, do you understand also that the statute has not really been enforced completely? It's really being challenged in court as we speak.
I know part of the law
really
is being appealed.
A lot of people
I understand
are leaving.
That. But nonetheless,
there's a lot of people leaving the state because of the economy of the United States. And what do you do when there's no work?
Ira.
Well, you leave. So I really don't think this is a consequence of the statute.
Ira, what he's obviously talking about is part of the state's appeal that they're trying to hold parts of the law which would have allowed police to question the immigration status randomly, and to those who, I guess, get pulled over, let's say, for speeding, they're allowed to ask them if they're a legal citizen or not. That part of the law is being appealed right now. But nonetheless, you know, he's saying that this law hasn't really taken an effect. So then how do you explain the 100,000 Hispanics that are fleeing the state of Arizona?
Well, first of all, it's not just SB 1070. There have been other laws instituted in Arizona over the past 5 or 6 years that have also created deterrence. And by the way, even with the injunction of the judge, a police officer may, they're simply not required to ask about immigration status if they reasonably suspect somebody is in the country illegally. So the police can still do that. But, you know, it has been a systematic removal of all the incentives that draw people to Arizona illegally. And we have seen the results. Illegal aliens have gotten the message. They have left Arizona, and these are heavily subsidized jobs that that we're talking about here. When you pay people low wages, it costs the taxpayers. If other states want to subsidize these workers, that's their choice. But Arizona has made the determination.
When you say other states or other cities subsidizing these workers, are you talking about sanctuary cities?
Yeah, you know, California.
What is a
lot of them are going
city?
To a lot of them are going
because
to New
Ryan
Mexico.
Because Ryan doesn't believe that sanctuary. Ryan doesn't believe
sanctuary
cities
city.
Exist.
A sanctuary city is where the
exist.
Local police, the local authorities say they will not cooperate with federal immigration authorities, that they will allow people to show up with their matricula cards
in
and access
words,
all kinds of government benefits.
Federal
that's
laws
not
in place,
true.
It is true. The bottom line is that Arizona has proven that it works, that if you set up laws and determine and you demonstrate a determination to enforce those laws, that illegal aliens, being rational people, will decide, you know what, we're not going to go to Arizona. And as you eliminate places in the country where people can go and stay illegally easily, what will happen is fewer illegal aliens will come, more will make the decision, like the 23,000 who left Arizona and went back to Mexico, more of them will make the decision to go back to their native countries, which is precisely what we want. We want to deter illegal immigration. That is the most effective form of enforcement.
All right, Riad, real quick, because
Julie,
we have to go.
Sure. There was a recent article that was published by Jessica Vaughn subsidizing sanctuary cities. They were claiming that they were actually receiving some monies from the Bureau of Justice Assistance and they were sanctuary cities. And it's really interesting. How can one thing go with the other? They're giving them money precisely for arresting illegal aliens and referring them to ICE authorities. So this is just a big joke. There's no such thing as a sanctuary city. If you want to say that any other city aside from Phoenix or any city in Arizona, it's a sanctuary city, go for it.
All right.
But there's
that's
not such
all the
a
time
thing,
we
and it's
have.
Just misleading.
That's all the time we have for today. Riad Gonzalez, thank you
very
much. And Ira Melman,
very
thank
welcome.
You, gentlemen.
Thanks.
Greg.